To use a container, drag an item, either multi-choice or multi-picts, onto your card. I'm going to resize and reposition this one. Then I will put my answers in each. First, I'll put in my correct answer. I only have one of those on this one, but you can have as many as you want. Then I will add my incorrect answer. Since all of my incorrect answers are going to be the same, I'm going to use a shortcut and select my incorrect answer, do a copy using my right-click mouse, and then paste to add it to the other boxes. You won't often use this, but if you do need to copy and paste, make sure you use the right-click. It's more reliable. Let's explore grid, flow, and fixed settings. With flow, the correct or incorrect answers, the items inside the container, will flow as you change the size and shape of the container. With grid, you specify the maximum width or the maximum number of objects you can have side by side in the container. So here I have two side by side. I will show you 4 and 7, and you'll notice how there's more space as I open it up on those layouts. It will also stretch to fill the space once I let go. Here it's left some space because I still have room to copy in and paste 3 more. This is the fixed setting. With fixed, the items inside the container do not move with the container, but they can be randomized. So here I am positioning in the way I want. This gives me some nice design options. You only want to randomize if they're about the same size. I'm going to show you now with multi-picts. Again, I go ahead and set the size and position of my container that I'm going to have the answers in. And then I select each box and go to my image picker to choose the image I'm going to have in it. With fixed, I do want to go ahead and set the size of each item. You'll see here I'm going to have these be about the same size because I'm thinking I may go ahead and set it to randomize. Only use randomize if each of your images is about the same size as the other. Otherwise, you'll get some very odd results during play. So this is a brief introduction to containers.